Getting started with LAMU. LAMU is a portable USB drive with software to store and organize all your media files, including photos, videos, and music. Everything LAMU needs to run is on the drive itself. No software will be installed on the computer. You can take LAMU and connect to any modern Windows computer and it will run. To start using LAMU, simply connect it to your Windows computer's USB port. The first time you plug LAMU into your computer, Windows might ask what you would like to do with it. From the list of options, choose Open Folder and View Files. The next time you connect LAMU, Windows will automatically open File Explorer and show the list of files in LAMU. In case Windows does not open File Explorer automatically, you can simply press the Windows key located at the bottom left corner of your keyboard and then press the letter E. From File Explorer, select the LAMU drive and you can see the files located on the LAMU root. Double-click startlamu.exe will start LAMU. Depending on the settings on your computer, File Explorer might not show the .exe extension. You can turn it on by clicking on View from the menu in File Explorer, then check the File Name Extensions box. While you are here, you can check the Hidden Items checkbox too, so you can see hidden files and folders if you like. Now you should see the startlamu.exe with the full name displayed on the LAMU drive. If you turn on Hidden Items in File Explorer, you will see a folder named LAMU. This is the folder where all the important LAMU files reside, including all the photos and videos you import into LAMU. If you have backup tools to backup your files, you should include the LAMU folder in the backups. The LAMU software has a backup utility included to help you backup LAMU files. We will demonstrate how to use the LAMU backup utility in a separate video. Double-click startlamu.exe to start the program. There is a simple registration form to register your LAMU. Fill out the form and submit. A window will open with tips for taking care of your LAMU. LAMU is a hard drive-based device, and you will be storing your precious memories on the device. Make sure to read through these tips to learn the best practices. In particular, make sure to always safely eject LAMU from Windows before unplugging LAMU. Sometimes, after you exit LAMU, the Safely Eject hardware tool still complains that the device is currently in use. This is typically because Windows System Process is doing some work on the drive. If you sign out Windows and sign back in, then run the Safely Eject hardware tool, it will usually work. The first time you start LAMU, since there are no photos to display, LAMU will ask if you want to import photos now. If you choose yes, you will be taken to the import wizard to begin importing photos. If you choose no, the main LAMU application window will be displayed. From the main application window, you can choose to import photos from the left menu. We will demonstrate the import process in separate videos. I'm going to choose no for now, so we can look at the main user interface of LAMU. LAMU user interface is divided into three areas: main menu, action bar, and the main view. On the left is the main menu. This is where you select different views to navigate your photo library. As you can see from the main menu, LAMU lets you view photos by timeline, people, places, maps, events, calendar, special days, albums, tags, folders, and favorites. LAMU has a built-in music manager and a central place for all of your videos. You can import photos from many different sources. You can export photos and share with family and friends. At the bottom of the main menu is the LAMU logo. When you click on the LAMU logo, you can set preferences, report issues, and update LAMU software. Next to the LAMU logo, there are three help buttons. When you click the top help button, LAMU will display a list of video tutorials related to the current view. The second Help button will show a guide and tips for the current view. The third Help button will open the PDF user manual. At the top of the window is the action bar. The action bar contains buttons relevant to the current view context. The buttons will change as you navigate to different views. If you are viewing a list of photos, the action bar will have options for selecting different thumbnail sizes. The rest of the screen is the main view for displaying photos.